Good morning, YouTube. Welcome to Vlogmas. I got the whole friends gang here. Got my cup off of Amazon, my friend's cup, and then this PJ set is from Walmart. It's like already fading. I've had it for probably 3 years at this point. Walmart had this probably, I want to say 3 years ago, and I wear it every single time that I self-tan. So I did self-tan last night. It does stick to my dry patches, so sometimes my face looks kind of funky the next morning, but I'm going to go ahead and wash that off. I just placed an order for Target Circle. I'm going to pick up some cat food, some mini bagels, cream cheese. My son really wanted mini bagels and cream cheese. And was that it? I think that was it. Because we have everything else. We just needed mainly cat food. That's the only thing. And I didn't feel like going into the store with three kids. So I did the drive-up option. So once that's ready, I'm going to hit the road. Kids already had breakfast, but right now I'm going to wash this off and wash my hair. I have some really neat hair care products coming in. One is actually coming in today I'm really excited for because it has amazing reviews. It's definitely the most expensive hair care product I've ever purchased, but it is this Orbe Serene Scalp Thickening Treatment right here. It had amazing reviews on Amazon. Oh, my battery's dying, I gotta charge it. It had amazing reviews on Amazon. It's targeted towards fine thin hair, especially thinning hair. It's supposed to help the follicles and help kind of make the hair look thicker, and with continued use, it's one of those products that actually helps the hair. Well, kind of like the mascara, you know how sometimes you wear a mascara and some mascaras are designed so that they actually help the lash fibers. My daughter's playing the piano in the background. Same with this, it has health benefits while kind of being like a styling product, so we will see. But that is my morning rant. Now I'm just gonna take a shower, and I still use Orbe products. I just have been loving them. This is my current lineup right now. I have the Orbe for Beautiful, and this one's for Volume. This one's for Magnificent Volume Shampoo. It's very lightweight, doesn't weigh the hair down at all, and I absolutely love the smell. And yes, I have some lash clusters that I took off probably like a week ago. I think these are the Lilac Street, their newest release, the Icon Lashes, and I didn't want to throw them out, so I was like, I'm keeping these, and I totally forgot about them. And then I have the Beautiful Color Glaze. I wasn't crazy about this at first, honestly. But then the more I used it, the more I fell in love with it. It's like an in-shower mask. And I noticed a huge difference in my hair when I use it and when I don't. It basically replaces your conditioner. You're supposed to use like once a week in place of your conditioner. And it's like an in-shower mask. You leave it in for a few minutes and your hair just feels silky, smooth. And I have fine, thin hair. So for my hair to be silky smooth and not be weighed down, like, it does weigh it down a little bit, but not as much as other super hydrating products. And I just have been really loving it. I think it's amazing for the hair. Then I got the Beautiful Color Conditioner. I was supposed to have the volumizing one, but they sent me the wrong one, and then it was too late to return it, so I was like, whatever, I'm just gonna keep it. And then this is rose gold conditioner I've had, my stylist gave me when I had like pink hair. I still might go back to pink hair once my hair is like super blonde. Then this is the purple shampoo that I use. It is amazing, in my opinion. It smells great. If it's hydrating, and I know that some people would say it's drying, but if you use it properly and you don't overdo it, I have found it not to be drying at all, and it smells so good, and it works very well. Just, you know, you always got to be very careful with purple shampoos because they do deposit color. But this one is fairly affordable. It's $17.99, I think, on Amazon, which is where I got it, bought it from. And I really, really like it. So if you have like brassy tones you want to get rid of and you want an affordable option, this is definitely more affordable than Orbe, but it's still kind of like a premium beauty brand product of sorts. So check that out. But I'm just gonna go ahead and take a shower. Took a shower, hair is all done, nice and fresh. Did my makeup. My order is ready, so I'm gonna go pick that up right now, and I think I'm gonna drop this off at my mom's house. I originally wanted to give this to her for Christmas, but I'm gonna give her something else. I'm interested to see how this works for her. These are hair fibers. I've heard of this brand and another one. I just can't remember the name of that one, but my mom's 68 now, and she has a lot of thinning hair, basically lost a lot of her hair when she was like 30, and then just got progressively worse and worse and worse. So she's at like the progressive stage of hair thinning. And this is not gonna make your hair grow thicker. These are just hair fibers so that it kind of conceals the scalp and makes it look realistic, like you have more hair than you actually do. So I'm interested to see how this works on her and see how she likes it. All right, we are home now. I did end up stopping by my mom's house. I tried the hair fibers on her, and I do think they're great for filling in, like making your hair kind of like a root spray. Did you guys ever try a root spray? But these are nice because they're very, very fine particles. There was one area in the back that it kind of like didn't want to grab onto the scalp, so almost felt like it was defeating the purpose. I feel like you have to have at least some hair coming out for it to grab onto, because it didn't seem like it was grabbing onto the scalp, more so the hair follicles around it, the hair fibers. So I don't know, for $25, I'll have her use it. I told her to try it out. She just wanted to like sample it, have her try it out and see what she thinks. But it's kind of expensive for $25. Hopefully she likes it. But I did buy coffee beans, got the cat food. I went to her house and I completely forgot that I wanted to get cookie cutter shapes. I thought I had some because I wanted to make sugar cookies with the kids. I could have sworn I had some. I do actually. I have hearts, which is totally not related to Christmas. And then I have this Paw Patrol. That's not gonna work. Saika, where are we
going?
We came to Babushka's house. I decided to come here. I think I'm gonna bake the cookies here. I was gonna stop by and just grab the cookie cutters from her because she has the cookie cutters. But I figured, why not just stay here and make them here? So we'll see how this goes. Might decorate them at home. We'll see how the time goes because it's already 3, gets dark at like 4:30. There's no greater feeling than coming home, changing into comfortable, comfy clothes. This is actually, I had somebody ask, this is from Shop Good To Be, Alex and Michael on YouTube. This is from probably, I wanna say, I think it was last year I got it. They haven't come out with Christmas merch this year, and I think it was like a one-time thing, like a limited edition, and then just changes to some sweatpants. Let me turn on the garland here. The sunset is gorgeous. I mentioned this in a previous video, but the sunsets in the wintertime are just absolutely stunning. So, hey Pepper, got the fire going. Kids are watching something on the tablet for now while I make the royal icing for this. And I just use a basic recipe I find on Pinterest with using meringue powder. I make a large base of white and then kind of separate it into bowls and make different colors. And I'm just gonna put it in these baggies to make it easy for the kids. The cookies, this recipe is so easy to use in my opinion, and it's actually good. It's not like that chewy sugar cookie recipe. This one's like nice and crumbly, but I will say, these are a little bit burned. My mom put them on broil, but that's okay. We're gonna cover them anyway. They're not like completely burned. They're just like a little bit brown. These are probably perfect, but I would say that roll them out to the thickness that you want them, because they don't rise. So whatever thickness you roll them out to, that's the way they're gonna stay. Even though they might rise a little bit, they fall back down. So just keep that in mind, but otherwise I'll leave the recipe down below because this is such an easy recipe to follow. All done with the cookies, semi cleaned up the kitchen fairly easy, and now I'm just gonna make myself, I'm like all pooped out from today. Didn't feel like I didn't do anything, but I'm just tired. But I wanna make myself a matcha for the night. I'm debating between iced or hot. I really love the iced ones. But this, I actually ended up ordering another packet like this because I love it so much. It's just such a great matcha powder. If you love milk-based matcha drink, this one I feel like works very well with milk. And if you first mix it with some hot water and use a frother, a handheld frother, to kind of get all the clumps out, add some honey for some sweetness. You can add as much honey as you want and then pour in steamed milk or, you know, cold milk if you do an iced drink. I feel like it's just such a delicious matcha latte. Otherwise, I'm going to end this video here. I hope you guys enjoyed hanging out with us, making these cookies. The royal icing recipe wasn't the best I've ever tried, but it wasn't too bad. Add a little bit of lemon extract to kind of give it a little bit of a tartness because there's so much powdered sugar in it. And then I'll link the recipe for the cookies down below because actually it was a pretty decent sugar cookie recipe. So hope you guys enjoyed hanging out with us, and I'll see you guys in the next one.